This not a drill. Bucket of ice on me, how should I chill? Scoping your mop, watch how I know how I'm rocking, you know how I'm built. Still in the trenches, we out in the field. If she in her bag, then it's Prada Chanel. The is fake, but she popping for real. Still that way. Run up if you feel that way. You can get this work, but the work don't ship, cause it really don't feel that way. Seen a whole lot of rapping and a whole lot of get like ice. Yesterday's price is not today's price. Talk to me nice. You know I'm an east side, big TDE, step a whole rep, that top dog since top ramen now, steak and lobster with a shrimp, fat.
Today, from AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas, it's a special Thanksgiving Day presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. And the Dallas Cowboys taking on Jalen Hurts and the Philadelphia Eagles.
Just a gorgeous fall afternoon in the heart of Texas. No weather to speak of. Sun out, roof open. Yes, yes, and yes. A great day for football at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Today, our Thanksgiving coverage continues with a good one here, as it'll be the Philadelphia Eagles taking on the Dallas Cowboys. Again, everyone, I'm Brandon Gordon, joined as always by Charles Davis. And Charles, you take a look at this Cowboy team entering play. They're hot as can be, winners of eight of their last nine games.
I don't know if you call this start a surprise exactly, but they've proven that they're going to be able to stand toe-to-toe with anybody.
It's a tradition that began in 1966, and off we go on a Thanksgiving afternoon in Dallas. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Philly's offense getting ready, and Jalen Hurts ready to lead them. The second-round pick who started his career at Alabama, then finished with an electric senior season at Oklahoma.
I like this guy, and the reason I do, he tends to stand an even keel. Doesn't let too much ruffle him. He will manage the game the way it needs to be managed, take what the defense gives him, and then he can strike at times. Had a touchdown pass. Yes, he had an interception last week, but he found a way for his team to win.
First and 10, it's Swift. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. These are his numbers from last week's contest. 17 carries, 81 yards.
And even though it's a short week, running backs love when they're in a groove, and that's exactly where he is right now. He's hoping to feast a little bit more here on Thanksgiving.
Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. Open man, that's Devontae Smith. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Hurts finding Smith for the Philly first. He'll drop to throw. Over the middle and hauled in by Osborne. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. 23 yards, the final tally. To the running game with Swift, and he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. Throwing is Hurts. It's complete to Brown, right side. That was play number 7 on this drive, and it got him 7 yards.
Well, safe to say the passing game has found a rhythm. He's now 4-4, but might need to be 5-5 to keep this drive going here as they face a third down.
And maybe perhaps you show a running play, right? Maybe a little play action here to go ahead and let him throw the ball downfield. I wouldn't get away from him flinging it, because 4-4 already, I think he's got a good chance of picking this one up here on third down.
As my dad used to tell me all the time, when you're getting ready to play a big-time game, especially when you have one going into a dome setting, better strap it up tight, because that crowd can really affect things.
Especially on third downs like the one we just saw there with the incompletion.
Now a battle for the football. It's caught. It's a touchdown. A.J. Brown, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Eagles' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Well, these guys have won 3 straight ball games, and another good start to this one out to the 6-0 lead.
And I've talked with so many different coaches, as have you along the way, and they always talk about winning streaks and the mood of a team and how much easier it is to actually prepare during that time. Guys are sharp, guys are focused, everyone's feeling good, and we're seeing it early in this one.
Extra point by McPherson, up and good.
And it's now a 7-0 game.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. Look at the Cowboys' offense as Dak Prescott gets ready to guide them.
It's a pretty bland game he had last time out. Ended up throwing 1 interception, didn't have a touchdown to offset it, but the team found a way to win. He found a way to lean on other parts of the offense that carried them through.
So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a 1st and 10 at their own 22. And they'll start the drive on the ground with Johnson. And able to break 1 tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. The numbers for Johnson in last week's game, pretty good, as he found himself in the end zone on 2 separate occasions.
And those are the most important numbers, because no matter what you pile up prior to the goal line, getting in is all that matters. Putting those numbers up on the board, and they love them when they're 6s.
Here's a throw to his... And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so our offense has to be ready each and every time to either equal or try and get us ahead and try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown given up.
And across the midfield stripe into Eagle territory.
2nd and a couple.
Prescott to throw it. Left side to Lamb. And he has another 1st down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles 39. Up the middle, Johnson
to the 36-yard line. Stop there. Here's 2nd and 7.
Now Prescott.
Open man, the tight end Luke Schoonmaker.
He's brought down in the red zone at the 18 after a gain of 18. 1st and 10.
And I feel a little bit like a traitor as a former defender, because that big man did not want to go down and refused to go down. If you're a defender and you'll get the right angle on a big tight end like him, he can run right through you like you're not even there. And he did a lot of that on that play.
So from inside the 20, here's 1st and 10 at the 18.
Here's Prescott. Flushed out right. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's 2nd down.
Prescott. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And the Cowboys are going to be set up with a first and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line. They'll try and run. This is Johnson. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. From the 2 now, second and goal. Now Prescott. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. Luke Schoonmaker, a 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Cowboys are able to match the opening drive touchdown against them with one of their own.
I do believe we came here to see a game, didn't we? And it looks like he's running what we call routes versus air. You just go out there with your offensive unit and throw the football with no defense. He's 5 for 5 on the opening drive.
He was on his game there for drive number one, but my only thing is now he can't go any higher than that. He was so perfect. Can he do it again later?
Yeah, all he cares about right now is making it 10 for 10, 15 for 15.
Keeping that going.
And he feels like he can get it done.
The extra point by McLaughlin is up and good. And we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. So back onto the field. Here come the Eagles for their second drive. As mentioned, this one of the hottest teams in the NFL, riding that winning streak into this one, but now playing here on Thursday night. Do you think that this helps or hurts their momentum?
Well, ordinarily, I'd say it hurts the momentum because now you've got that short week. But when a team's playing as well as they are, it actually allows them to down focus and only worry about themselves and less about their opponent. So when you're playing well, you just worry about the things you're doing well and let the opponent deal with that.
You look at this Cowboy defense. They were very good last week in the win over the Saints.
And what I saw on film was nearly an unstoppable pass rush. They had 5 sacks last week, plenty of hurries. So now do you just max protect on offense, keep everyone in and run, you know, 1 or 2 receiver routes to make sure your quarterback stays up? We'll soon find out.
After the loss to start out, here's 2nd and 11. Here's Hurts to throw. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. 7-7, our score after one. Start of the second quarter, and it's the Eagles in possession. So here's a 3rd and 14 as they've got it as we resume action. This short throw caught by Goddard, and he'll be stopped at the 27-yard line, well short of the first down marker. They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and that's going to bring up the 4th down. On 4th down, J.K. Scott ready to punt it away. That's a 49-yard punt, 8 though on the return. And it will be 1st and 10 as they take over. Dak and the Cowboys ready for their next possession. 5 for 5 that last drive. Touchdown pass as well. He was clicking. Receivers, I don't want to be cliche, but running really solid routes too.
And what I love about it is when you look across any team, all right, the body types of the receivers are usually different. The way that they get open, different as well. Some of them use power to get open. Some of them use those head fakes and subtle moves. Some of them just use pure speed. And the really good ones, when they're established, they know how to push off at the end of a route, too.
From the 35, here's 2nd down and 2. Off the play fake, Prescott. Open man is Duvernay. And he'll have it past midfield, almost to the 40, before being taken down. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. Give up the middle to Johnson. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
The Cowboys at 9-1 on the year. They've been as hot as anyone. The win last week makes it 9 out of 10.
And partner, to me, this is a team that no matter what the matchup, they're up for the fight. They are really suited for the postseason the way they're playing right now, and I would not want to face them come playoff time.
And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5. Here is third down and 4. Prescott down. He's got his target. That's complete. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 22-yard line. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
All right, let's just go ahead and walk through this one pretty easily, right? Blast off the line of scrimmage, get downfield to a certain point, usually around 8 to 10 yards, turn around and make sure the quarterback sees your numbers and set yourself up for the pass.
A well-executed curl route by Charles Davis. Prescott looks to throw on first. That's into a crowd and intercepted. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick six TD. And on that one, with six defensive backs, did he need to be more careful throwing the football? I mean, I guess obviously in hindsight he did, but.
Yeah, hindsight, but even in foresight, when you got six defensive backs on the field, you just know you're going to get multiple coverages. You're never sure what you're going to see. But the biggest one is you don't have much reaction time for your receivers to go get the football because those guys, they're the best cover guys on the field. They go get it. And on that play, they took it the other way for 6 points.
Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. Coming out with a jumbo package to start the drive. They'll start on the ground, Carter, and they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Throwing, Prescott. Over the middle, hauled in by Lamb. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. Here's Prescott. Fall incomplete. Here's second and 10. To throw is Prescott. And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down. And again, it's Prescott. And that's going to be incomplete. Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt,
and it will be Eagles football first and 10. Philadelphia's offense ready to give us another look.
The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
Well, if an offense is going to throw the ball in this part of the field, any pass rusher will tell you that's his favorite part. Gets a chance to get after the quarterback. It's almost like a reverse red zone. They can create points using their defense, and this time they take their man down.
After the sack, oh, they're staring at a challenge basically from the other side of town. It's second and a country mile.
Swift going to try up the middle.
And he's going to be taken down shy of the five-yard line. Facing the prospect of a punt from their own end zone, they need some cushion. Let's see what they can do on third down.
They'll stay on the ground with Swift.
And he'll be taken down for a loss back at the three. Tough sledding. They lose a yard there on third.
Well, that was a third and long run, and to me, that was just a wave the white flag kind of a situation. Obviously, they don't want to risk the chance of throwing it downfield and risking a turnover in this section of the field.
Here's J.K. Scott now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he's able to get it out quickly, and this is not a bad kick here. It'll be a net of 40 yards following a punt of 44. And this offense will take over right at the midfield stripe with a first and 10.
Dallas offense set for this next drive. As we eat closer and closer to intermission, Charles, remember last time out they punted. They would love to get points here, especially if this is going to be their final possession of the first half.
Yeah, and this is what close games feel like because the pressure is on both sides, but sometimes the pressure is a little bit higher on the team with the slight edge because they're trying to hold on to that, trying to increase it. Let's see how this one continues.
Second down, Prescott.
Short pass taken in by Schoonmaker.
Third catch of this first half for him, and this one is a first down. We've hit the two-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. The Cowboys looking to get going again in a hurry.
Prescott, he throws it on the move but can't connect as that falls incomplete.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Prescott from the gun.
That's over the middle to Schoonmaker.
And he'll be taken down well before the first at about the 36-yard line. They do get 10 back, but still a ways to go on fourth. Chase McLaughlin now for the field goal try. From the left hash, this from 53 yards out. That's running out of steam and it won't get there. He left it just short, no good, and this will stay at a 7-point game.
The Eagles offense is going to take over late in this first half. And with good starting field position and three timeouts as well in their pocket, no reason not to try and put a late scoring drive together.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. Obviously not the intended goal last drive. They had to punt the football, but still they've got the lead here and now a chance to add on to that lead if they can get points on this drive. First and 10 upcoming. After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's first and 10. Hurts sets up to throw it before he picks up 7 yards. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Second down, here's Hurts. Looking for A.J. Brown again, and he's got it again. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. Hurts connecting there with Brown for the Eagles first. Back to throw here. Looking left side and he's got a man. That's Smith. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Hurts. This will be caught by Brown. And A.J. going to pick up an Eagles first down as he'll get this down inside the 20. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. McPherson's kick is good. And they will move up by 10 now, 17-7. So good work there to get points just before the half as they add on to their lead.
As trite as it sounds, every little bit helps. That's exactly what they're going for. Anytime you get a chance to put points on the board, you take it.
And they didn't leave the other side with much time at all on the clock. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And with only 9 seconds remaining, well, not much time, we'll see how they play this. And this is going to be a Cowboys first down as he's got this up to the 35-yard line. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. Final play of the half, Prescott. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. So we've hit halftime on Turkey Day here in Dallas. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Happy Thanksgiving again to everybody at home as we take a look ahead to what's coming up both later today and this weekend. One of the best of the early games, we'll highlight it there. The Giants in for a stern test at home at MetLife Stadium as they'll square off with the New Orleans Saints. Excellent games in the late afternoon window as well, one being out in Los Angeles, where it'll be the Rams taking on the Pittsburgh Steelers. And lastly, we'll be tuned in on Sunday night for what should be a great one between the Green Bay Packers and the Minnesota Vikings.
Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. A 10-point game, 17-7 the score as we get back to it on EA Sports. And no fireworks to start the half. This will be a touchback. The Cowboy offense set to go to begin this third quarter. This offense, Charles, had a strong first half throwing the football, at least in terms of yardage, but that hasn't translated so far on the scoreboard as they begin the third quarter here, trailing and looking for a little momentum.
Yeah, you're right about that because, you know, let's face it, in the first half, most of their focus was in the passing game, and to their credit, resulted in a healthy amount of yardage. So I would think that at halftime, they're going to anticipate that defense loosening up a little bit to try and cover the passing lanes. They've got to get the running game going, and there should be some gaps to run through now.
Meanwhile, Prescott's throw here, hauled in by Kupp. And he's going to be down at the 35, gain of 7. The catches for him just keep piling up in his career. He's now at 1,024. And that ties Isaac Bruce, the number that he had back in the day.
Yeah, part of the greatest show on turf. And remember, Isaac Bruce, Torrey Holt combined for nearly 2,000 catches in their careers. He might get to 2,000 himself with the numbers he's posting up there. Keeps himself in great shape. He might go for it.
Call it a gain of five as they move the sticks. These two teams met up earlier in the year back in week four, and it was the Cowboys winning on the road, so they look for the sweep here back home in Arlington. They go to Johnson again, and this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Well, if these guys are going to chop into that deficit, they're going to have to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage would be found.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. Off the draw, here's Johnson. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. Out to the flat here for Johnson. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And that's going to make it fourth down.
Brandon, it certainly looked like they had that play defended well, but it still almost worked. Got it to the running back. He wound up getting really good yardage out of it. But it was third and long, and they were able to rally and stop it before he could get to the marker.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he'll punt it away for the second time. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. And they won't risk defending a return here. That one's out of bounds, and it'll be spotted at the 14-yard line. So here are the Eagles now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their own 14-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2. They're going to look to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Osborne. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. They'll run the draw here with Swift. And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely neutralized. Now second and 9. They'll drop to throw. They're unable to connect, but a late flag comes in. And the contact may have come too early. So pass interference, the call there. Always, obviously, Charles, such a subjective call. You agree with the penalty?
Well, from where we're standing right now, I think the officials are tightening things up here in the second half. Maybe a defender gets away with that in the first, but this time the flag comes out, and I think it's a good call.
From just shy of midfield, Hurts. He's got Dallas Goedert, his tight end, over the middle. They'll go to the air here on third and 2. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 37. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
Well, sometimes our pregame meetings do pay off, don't they? What did the guys in the locker room call him?
Well, they said it with a chuckle. They called him Old Reliable.
Yeah, that means he doesn't move quite as fast as he used to, but he still knows all the tricks, doesn't he? Even that little gentle push-off in order to get open, he finds a way to pick up a first down.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. They work now on second and nine. From the gun, it's Hurts. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. Micah Parsons in there for the sack, and he's closing in on the all-time record. That's number 19 on the year.
The passing game's been struggling a bit today, and that was the latest example. Haven't been getting much yardage out of it, and now on his back after the last play, he faces third and long.
So after that sack, Hurts and the Eagles, tough spot here, third and long. They'll look to throw. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Osa Odigizuwa, he's the one to get him this time, and back-to-back sacks brings up fourth down. Third and long, you knew that he was going to throw it. He just couldn't find anybody to throw it to.
Yeah, and it shouldn't have been a surprise, but that was perfect execution of their nickel defense. That fifth defensive back, the extra defender, he really tightened up things downfield in coverage, and they were able to get to him in the pocket.
Here's J.K. Scott now as he's on to punt for Philadelphia. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively, just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each play work. Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back to some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. They give to Johnson going right. And this winds up a gain of four to the 41. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Looking to throw, Prescott. He's going to get that to his running back out of the backfield. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. We're on to the fourth here on Thanksgiving Day. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Arlington. It's the Cowboys in possession of the football, but they trail here as we begin the fourth quarter of play. Prescott now from the 50. That's taken in by Duvernay. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Back to throw. Throwing quickly there, but it's incomplete. They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. Prescott yet again. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 22-yard line. Again, he'll drop to throw. And this is caught for a Cowboy touchdown. A 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Cowboys have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. They went empty backfield, all their weapons out wide, so there really was no secret here to what they were going to do.
No secret, but they still had to execute it, and they still had to protect the guy throwing the ball, because oftentimes when you empty the backfield, people bring pressure at you. They managed to hold in there and successfully complete the touchdown pass.
McLaughlin for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it a 17-14 game. So that drives 7 plays in length, and it culminates in a Dallas touchdown. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. So here are the Eagles to take over. They're working on a 4-game winning streak, and they lead this one as well right now as they start 1st and 10. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And that's going to be caught downfield by Brown. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. The catch and run going to wind up netting him 33 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for 1st and 10. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. Oh, Bananas Osborne, he's got him. So the completion good for 6 yards. And it's 2nd down. Throwing is Hurts. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's 3rd down. They'll look to throw again. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And 4th down now coming up.
When you're running the slant, timing is everything. And against that man coverage, there was no space available, and incompletion as a result.
So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. This to swell the lead to 6. And that is no good. Oh, he missed it just wide of the upright. And that will keep this a 3-point game. The Dallas offense back out onto the field. Well, they didn't fall behind any further thanks to that missed field goal, but still staring at this 4th quarter deficit. Maybe an important 4th quarter miss as this stays a 3-point game.
Yeah, now overtime is very much in the equation here. Just what you mentioned, a 3-point game.
Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. Hassan Reddick from that outside linebacker spot gets in there. It's a loss of 9.
I thought there at the end he may have had a chance to release that, but that pocket closed a little too quickly and down he went.
Yeah, he was certainly trying to do everything he could to extend the life of the play, probably counting in his head 1, 2, and then he ran out of time.
And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. 2nd and 19. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. Over the middle, complete. It's Lamb. And the stiff arm made it a pretty little run. Not a huge gain, but a nice chunk of yardage. It'll go down as a gain of 6, and they'll be facing a 3rd and 12.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
And this offense on 3rd down today, they've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is 3rd down and 12. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And to the 49-yard line, but no further, and obviously he is well short of the first.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helps to have a guy who can turn it loose, and boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
Comes the Cowboys punter as he's on here to punt it away. And he gets it away. A directional kick going toward the sideline. And this will depend on the spot as it sails out of bounds. And they'll say it sailed out at the 10-yard line. So well done there. And these punters, they get more specialized and better each and every year, don't they?
They sure do. And now it's really not the American punters. It's the Australian punters with their kicking academies and that flat drop and just kind of kicking the nose of the football. They're able to almost stop it where they want to, like a good golfer can check one up.
On the ground, it's Swift to start the drive. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. Once again, it's Swift. They had a very short pickup there across the 15 to the 16. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a third and about four for a first. Play. Eighth catch for him now. He's been a big factor, and it's a first down. And they're on third and short. They just tried to spread the field. It worked.
And I think that the spreading of the field, the extra receivers, has really become the next in the evolutionary chain in the NFL. Go all the way back in that situation, you're handed to the fullback, right? As we evolve, maybe you pitched it to your tailback. Now you spread the field, and you have your choices of where to throw it and complete it for a first down.
On first down, Hurts. Pressure from his right, and he goes down hard, flat on his back. Parsons able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
Well, it's been a little bit of feast or famine because he's thrown for decent yardage, and obviously they've got the lead, Charles, but now he's been sacked four times.
And what I'm focusing on is his toughness in the pocket, because you mentioned the feast or famine part. He's played well in between being dumped on his back, but every time he's had a chance to throw the football, he's been impressive.
Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. He's going to get that to Swift underneath. And he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just one. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Here's Hurts to throw. And he'll get this into the hands of Swift once again. And this will not get close to the first down marker as he's brought down at the 26. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They're looking at a fourth down now as they try to hold on to this lead for dear life.
On is the punter, Scott, here as he gets this one away.
Fielded just inside the 30. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. A nice return there of 11 to help mitigate a good punt. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. So Dak and the Cowboys down 17-14, a minute 51 on the clock. Their four-game winning streak in great danger. They begin the drive with Johnson, and he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line.
They'll come up now. This is second and long.
Prescott's throw is on target to Duvernay. And I believe the referee's been buzzed. Yeah, they want to take another look at this call, and it's certainly a big one here late in a tight game. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, it certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call. So the officials and the folks in New York got a second look at this one, and the call is going to be overturned.
Prescott. Oh, Prescott stripped, and it's picked up by the Eagles. And they're going to be set up in the red zone right around the 17-yard line.
Well, that simply is a missed opportunity. They're in position. If they take the ball downfield and score, they've got a chance to win the game. Instead, they cough it up. I don't think next week at practice is going to be a whole lot of fun for him.
On the other side, no bigger time to force a turnover when you've got that small lead.
Yeah, and when you look at it from the offense's perspective, taking care of the ball is so important. I know they're going to have all kind of ball security drills in practice all next week.
We got to have two hands on the football here as they run on first down.
And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11.
Here's a second and 5. He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball. And that should do it. He's got a first down. And the Eagles, they can run it out from here.
And they'll indeed take a knee. The Cowboys signal for their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. And they will take a knee here.
Down to a knee goes Hurts, and that is going to be that.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to swell the lead to 6. So fly, Eagles, fly. It's a victory for Philadelphia. And it was a bit of a strange game. They were held scoreless through the entire second half, but their first half output, that's enough to carry them to victory.
And that's an odd game to watch, isn't it? Because when we saw the output in the first half, you think to yourself, okay, they've got something working here. They know what they're doing. They'll continue that along. But instead, it's goose eggs in the second half. Fortunately, enough of a cushion and enough defense to carry them home.
So for the Eagles, their playoff chances take an uptick as they move to 7-4. And they'll get a few extra days to get ready for next week. Meanwhile, for the Cowboys, they go down to defeat for just the second time in 11 games so far. And they'll try to get back on the beam next week as they'll head to Tampa to take on the Bucks. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gauden. This is the NFL on EA Sports.